Let's start a new project using the MIP plugin template. We'll call it Client Plugins. As we know from earlier, the template creates many different plugins, including a Workspace plugin. Let's focus on that. If we scroll down to the init method, we can see that three rectangles are first defined. They are then added to the View and Layout Item class, which represents an entire view layout with potentially several items. Let's start editing the rectangles first. We want to modify the Workspace plugin to contain only two view items. Notice the indexing that is marked in the first comment. Next, we need to remove the code referring to the first rectangle we just removed. We also need to edit the index numbers to reflect the change. Since the template-generated code already includes an HTML view item, we can simply modify it to our needs. In this case, we are going to point the web browser to the free e-learning that Milestone provides. This is useful for smart client operators who may want to deepen their knowledge in the XProtect software. We leave the first view item as is for now. We will come back to this code later. Let's also edit the name property to better reflect what the Workspace plugin does. Let's build the project and copy the files to the MIP plugins directory. You are familiar with the process by now. Remember, plugin.def must be included the first time. After copying the files and logging in to the Smart Client, we can see our new e-learning tab in the Smart Client. Let's click on it to make sure it works as expected. Of course, this example is quite simple, but it demonstrates that you can get an entire Smart Client window devoted to your plugin. Additionally, this tab can be dragged to another monitor or a floating window, so an operator can always view it. In addition to using the built-in view item elements in the Workspace plugin, you can just as well use your own custom view items. We will do that next.